Hey, horse people. I scared Buddy when I said, hey, horse people. Last night I came out here, had a skunk, caught him in a cage. When you catch a skunk, if you put him in that cage, putting towels around it helps you so you don't get squirted and he can't see and you can approach from the side. The problem is, when they're trapped, they try to dig their way out and they tear that paper up. Well, or they tear the cloth up. Well, I was trying to stick that back on there and I got squirted. So I was skunked out last night, wasn't in a happy mood. My boots are out there airing out from the skunk. Already washed the clothes. So I go let this little sucker out. I drive him, he squirts on my truck as I'm putting him in the back of the truck. So now my truck, me, everybody but Buddy smells like a skunk. And I come back, and there's this little sucker over here. If I can zoom in on him, where's he at? Here, little buddy. Oh, there he is. And I come back and he tries to ambush me in a hay room. Squirts at me, squirts my side of the wall over there. And so luckily I was able to grab my trusty 357 out of that bag there. And had a little midnight shootout. I won. Well, I won the end game. I still got skunked. Anyway, I had to talk about, I think I'm going to label this just to piss off women, why I hate women with multiple horses. All right. I don't know if y'all can hear that. Somebody's going to complain. Can you not film next to your little wind thing? It was spinning, making noise. Shut up. I'm not in the mood, people. Oh yeah, somebody else asked me this question. I'm trying to get all my little questions out since I ain't got any horsey stuff. Somebody asked how I made this thing right here. Because they wanted to make a thing. These are just 4x6s. Instead of a 4x4, they're 4x6s. They were already concreted in the ground, so they were solid. I found these telephone poles in a lot they were clearing for houses. They cut down some old poles. The guy says, hey, if you can load them off, you can have them. So I got these telephone poles, cut the telephone poles, took a saw and cut two slivers, and then took a hammer and just the two parts that I cut sideways right here, I just took a hammer or a wood chisel kind of deal, screwdriver, anything will work, and you hammer it in there, and then it just set right on top of here. And I put it down on the ground because these are straight, and I measured it, and I marked it, and then I cut it. And then once I got this to where it sets on here nice, I drilled a hole right down the middle of this to the middle of this, and I put a long lag bolt. It comes down about here. And then when you put your lag bolt in, squirt some putty in there, because where things rot is where water gets in when it rains and it sets. So I put putty all around here and all straight down the hole before I screwed it in. That way when I screwed it in, all that putty expanded and then it dried. Then I just wiped off the excess. I even put putty around here so it wouldn't get underneath the wood, but I don't know if that helped or not. And anyway, that's how I built this thing. Not a big deal. So, I don't even know, because the sun's right in my eyes. If y'all can see my head while I'm over there talking, I'll move this up just a little bit. Not that you want to see my ugly mug, especially when I'm about to go off on women. The wind's coming this way. Alright. So I'm driving home. There's a place that's got some good catfish right up by the Oklahoma-Texas border. It's right by the casino. It's called the Windstar Casino, and I think the place is called River Ridge Restaurant or something. Good catfish. Excellent catfish. I'm not a big catfish guy. I mean, I can eat it, but this guy's got really good fried. He lightly batters it. Good catfish, good hot food. He does barbecue sausage, all that. He also does pretty good chicken fried steak, but God, he lives not too far from me. He works, he owns the place. He owns a farm way back out here and then drives there for a few days a week. But anyway, I'm at this place. So if anybody ever drives right on the Oklahoma-Texas border by 35, you're gonna notice on the west side of the road, there's a ratty place with a mobile home that's torn down and crap everywhere and bad fencing and about 40 freaking horses. And I've seen these horses there, and they look like they got hay. I don't know if it's a rescue. I don't know what it is. I've seen all the horses out there, and there's some cute little horses, because all horses are cute when they're little. So this horse, a lot of these horses are youngsters, so I'm sure it's got some crazy breeder. I won't say woman or man, because I don't know. Odds are it's a woman. But there's some crazy breeder that's breeding all these damn babies. So I'm driving back from eating my catfish, relaxing, drinking my iced tea. And I see these seven baby horses. Oh shit, I left my water on. I see these seven baby horses on the side of the road. Okay, now let's just say this log is the highway, okay? The lady's property's over here. There's a service road here. And then there's a fence line. Well, her horses are between here, the service road, and then her property. And they're running around. And as I'm driving, I'm like, damn, that's kind of odd. Then I see this crazy lady in a truck come barreling out. You know, of course, she's got a big, nice, fancy, white, jacked up dually with a fifth wheel and a bale of alfalfa in the back of the truck. Come driving out of this property like a freaking maniac, scaring the horses further down the road so they're more apt to run the highway. You got cars, Mack trucks, 35 right on the border heading back and forth. These horses are dead if they head to the road. They look scared because they're out of their environment, but luckily they're eating their grass along the side of the fence line. So they're perfectly safe. So I pull over on the side of the highway and I go, this ain't good. So I have an option. I need to take my video camera out and watch these horses get trashed, or I can get out of my car and try to go help. Well, of course, my dumb ass went out and tried to help. So, ladies out there driving around up and down the service road like a freaking bat out of hell, trying to think these horses are going to see this alfalfa and suddenly follow her. So she's just scaring the horses and scatter them so that the herd was nice and tight, eating together, not bothering anything. Somebody who understands a horse could have walked up there, put a lead rope or something on the head horse, and probably walked the herd and it would have been over. Now, that's what a horse person would do. Not some crazy breeder lady. Now, I don't even know if she's breeding, if she runs some rescue, she's starting some equipment. I don't know what the hell her story is. All I know is she's a damn idiot. She's racing around gonna kill these horses, scatter them in a highway. So I stop her and I'm like, shit, are these even your horses? Cause you're acting like a freakazoid. So she gets out of the truck, she's like, goddamn FedEx, didn't lose the gate, they left the... I said, can we worry about why the horses are out after we get them back in? Cause right now there's cars that are getting them hurt. Well, I don't know if I can catch them, they're not very handleable. They're all these excuses. And I'm like, well, if you stop yelling, maybe we won't jack them up and start them in a freaking stampede. So she looks at me like, who the hell is this crazy guy? Well, I'm just some guy who don't want to see a horse get run over. You're pissed off at FedEx for leaving your gate open and wanting to blame everybody instead of worrying about your horses. Because it was all about her. She was embarrassed. She didn't know. I didn't know if somebody else or she called the cops. Because now here comes cops. Here comes one unit. He blocks the service road. Which is okay, the service road wasn't that bad, but that's cool. So the cop gets out of the car and he stands by his car. He's like, you know, I'm not messing with this shit. I'm not gonna get blamed. I'll just stand here. So I'm kind of observing the herd. They're eating. I got her kind of back on her truck or moved or I don't know what she did, but she, as soon as she sees the cop, she wants to run over to them. Goddamn FedEx! FedEx came and left the gate open and they left my horses out and I told him to close it. And I'm just like, Jesus freaking Christ. Are you kidding me? So she's nagging him, which I'm glad. And he's looking at me like, what the hell is she? Is she with you? And I'm just like, yeah, I just pulled over the side road. I'm trying to help these horses. So I go over and I'm watching these horses. So I'm looking for who's the lead horse, who's the high horse, who if I can catch one horse, who's showing the most confidence. Because they're all babies. They're all one or two. So they're all pretty immature and pretty scared. And anytime crazy lady drives by with her bale of hay like a maniac, they scatter. So I'm like, okay, obviously she ain't freaking a herd leader. So I'm looking at these horses and I notice this one sorrow is kind of like leading the pack. And he's kind of as he moves, the other herd kind of follows with him, and they don't let him get too far. So, all right, that's the one I'm going to get. So, I'm standing over there, and she's running. Of course, my truck is way up by the highway. My truck's parked on a highway, so I had to go down this berm, across the service road, and then I'm at the horses. So I say, okay, let me see how close this horse is. Maybe I can get him to lock on, see if maybe I can touch him by the mane or guide him by his head, see if he'll let me touch him. So I went over a couple times. I got close to one. Guess who comes over? Oh, if you can catch him, we can lead the other ones in. Just, of course, the horse is like, what? I'm out of here. And I'm like, oh my God, you're killing me, lady. So I said, do you have at least a halter in a truck besides a bale of hay? No, I don't have a halter in the truck. The halter's at the house. I saw FedEx get it, and FedEx left the gate open. And I'm like, oh my God. Meanwhile, there's a freaking dog, a black and white dog, that's running around the horses, barking and biting at their hips, chasing them when they're trying to run. And I'm like, is that your dog? Yeah. I said, can you catch him? No, he jumped the fence. FedEx left the gate open. I was like, shut the hell up. I don't like FedEx either, but I ain't worried about FedEx running out in the street getting their ass run over. Oh, so I go back to my truck, grab a halter lead rope, go up that one horse. I start walking up to it. I get close. She's like, yep. I said, would you please be quiet? Because when you talk, you get the horses moving and they're not listening to me. I'm trying to catch your horse and help you. So she had an attitude. She stands there like this. So I get up to the horse. I pet the hip. I pet the shoulder. Here she comes. If you can just grab his neck. I step away from the horse because I know the horse. I'm already putting pressure on it. She's coming over. If I don't back away, he's either going to kick me, run through me, or go. So I move away because dumbass is coming in. And she comes in, here, I got him. And she puts her arms around him. Give me the rope. Give me the rope. I got him. I was like, calm down, please. So I walk over. I put the rope around the horse's head. She goes, if you could just lead him, the rest of them will follow. And I said, I got it. I'll lead him in. I said, just stay on the road so you don't jack these others up. Guess where she goes? By then, another cop has showed up. So now they got two cops blocking the roads. She goes to the other cop. Goddamn FedEx, man! I was like, oh my God, somebody please drive off the highway and run this idiot over. So I'm leading a horse and the other horses are following. I'm like, great, this is perfect. Well, she decides to walk from this cop to that cop. Meanwhile, she messes up the herd. They see her coming and the herd splits off. And I'm just like, you're killing me. So I take this horse that I got on here and I try to make him do a circle and lunge him, because sometimes when a horse sees another horse trot, it gets their attention. And since he's the lead horse, if he's trotting, they'll look. So I make him do a loop and they look. Of course, they don't want to come because crazy lady's standing in between me and the herd now. So I said, screw it. At least I could save one. Let me go get this horse in. So I get this horse in. As I get him by the gate, I see the horses are kind of far down there. She's still yelling about FedEx, not helping. Carrying around half a flake of hay, like somehow that's gonna save the day. Hey, I got hay, look at me, freaking idiot. So the horses don't come. I finally get to the gate and I go, hey, why don't you try to get the horses to come this way? So she looks at me like, I'm in the middle of bitching about FedEx and you're screaming at me. I'm just like, so I go, screw it. I walk in, finally the horses kind of scatter. They see him going in, he got excited, they run that way. Well, as soon as they get to the gate, here comes crazy lady running to catch up. And I'm like, you're killing me. So they scatter at the gate and go away from the gate. And I go, you know what? I just walk the horse as far away as I can from the other horses, hopefully to create a draw. She finally gets out there, gets in her truck, backs up. The horses somehow, by the grace of God, got in the gate. She pulls in the gate, and I'm thinking she's going to close the gate. Hell no! She comes running after me way down here. Oh, thank you! FedEx left the damn gate out! I took my shit off that horse. I walked by her. She's like, thank you! I didn't say a damn word. I went over, I shut the damn gates, and I left. And then people go, Rick, why are you always picking out women? You hate women! I hate stupid women that they got a clue and they get all these damn horses and put them in danger, and then the horses got to pay because they ain't got a voice in the situation. They got no vote. They got no choice. They're just stuck with the crazy breeding lady. That's why I don't like women, horse women that act like idiots. If you got a brain and you learn and you understand horses, I got no problem if you're male or female. I got a problem with idiot males that go out there and spur and bit and do all kind of stupid shit with the horses. I call them a dummy too. But it just happens every time I run into a crazy situation, it's a crazy breeding lady woman in this situation. Oh! Go turn my damn water off. Lady got me so jacked up. Rick, you just hate women. You come here with that hate woman shit, I'm banning you from the channel. So you come and make that, and it's the last comment you make. I do not want to hear this crap. This lady put those horses in danger. She made everything about her. She had excuses. Her dog jumped the fence. FedEx left the gate open. She doesn't have a halter because she didn't have time. The only thing she got is a damn flake of hay and a whole bale of hay in the back of her big fancy truck, driving around like Miss Horsewoman, don't know a damn thing but how to get her horses killed. And if you don't like it, well then tough. I don't care. Buddy, you're a good boy. Buddy, Mr. T, you're good boys. Hope that thing's making a lot of noise for anybody who wants to complain.